Thank you. Major James Ropack, Special Forces, United States Army, for allowing us the privilege of folding the flag that draped his coffin prior to interment at Arlington National Cemetery. The flag folding ceremony represents the same religious principles on which our great country was originally founded. The portion of the flag denoting honor is the canton of blue containing the stars representing the states our veterans served in uniform. The canton field of blue dresses from left to right and is inverted only when draped as a pall on the casket of a veteran who has served our country honorably in uniform. The United States Armed Forces, at the ceremony of retreat, the flag is lowered, folded in a triangle fold, and kept under watch throughout the night as a tribute to our nation's honored dead. The next morning, it is brought out at the ceremony of reveille, run aloft as a symbol of our belief in the resurrection of the body. These are the symbols for the folds of the flag. The first fold is a symbol of life. The second fold is our belief and eternal life. The third fold is made in honor and remembrance of the veteran departing our ranks and who gave a portion of his or her life for the defense of our country to attain peace throughout the world. Please be seated. The fourth fold represents our weaker nature. As American citizens, trusting in God, it is to Him we turn in times of peace as well as in times of war for His divine guidance. The fifth fold is a tribute to our country, where in the words of Stephen Decatur, our country, in dealing with other countries, may she always be right, but it is still our country, right or wrong. The sixth fold is for where our hearts lie. It is with our heart that we pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The seventh fold is a tribute to our armed forces, for it is through the armed forces that we protect our country and our flag against all enemies, whether they be found within or outside the boundaries of our republic. The eighth fold is a tribute to the one who entered into the valley of the shadow of death, that we might see the light of day and to honor our mother for whom it flies on Mother's Day. The ninth fold is a tribute to womanhood, for it has been through their faith, love, loyalty, and devotion that the character of the men and women who have made this country great have been molded. The tenth fold is a tribute to Father, for he too has given his sons and daughters for the defense of our country since he or she was first born. The 11th fold, in the eyes of Hebrew citizens, represents the lower portion of the seal of King David and King Solomon and glorifies in their eyes the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The 12th bowl, in the eyes of a Christian citizen, represents an emblem of eternity and glorifies in their eyes God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The 13th bowl, or when the flag is completely folded, the stars are uppermost, reminding us of our national motto, In God We Trust. After the flag is completely folded and tucked in, it has the appearance of a cocked hat, ever reminding us of the soldiers who served under General George Washington and the sailors and Marines who served under Captain John Paul Jones and were followed by their comrades and shipmates in the U.S. Armed Forces, preserving for us the rights, privileges, and freedoms we enjoy today. This ceremony is the same as that used when the flag drapes the coffin of a departed serviceman or woman, so we may maintain our freedom today. At this time, I would like all active duty and all who have served this great country in the Army, Navy, Marines, Air Force, Coast Guard, Merchant Marine, all police, firefighters, and EMT, please stand and be recognized. At this time, if you would all please stand and recite with me the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing during the playing of caps. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Bugler! Sound checks!
Thank you. musical salute to our first responding service members. And as you hear your song played, please stand if you are able to.
So this is how this works. My drummer is going to play 8 bars of Street Kings, for those of you who are veterans will recognize from long marches in the hot sun. And then a roll off, and we'll start a tune. And the tune will represent either first responders or one of the services. The first one we're doing is Bravura to represent all of the first responders. Then we'll do the services in order, in the official DOV order. And I know some of you are going to come to me afterwards and say, no, wait, no, the Navy comes before the Marine Corps. So I promise you, the order I have them in is the true order. So when you hear the song that represents you, or songs plural for some of us, stand and be recognized. And you may sing along if you want. I'm thinking though, when we get to the Merchant Marine song, nobody knows the words, but go for it. All right, so here it is. Bravura's first, this is first responders and firefighters. Drummers on the head.
Thank you.
some services. I did return a salute to the ones I wore. Okay, that's what that was about. Also, I want to do one more thing, because this is about... It just keeps playing itself. Wonderful instrument, though. This is about not just the first responders and we veterans and our active duty counterparts. This is about our wives and husbands who sit home and wonder, are we coming home yet? It's about the children who follow their families all over the world and wonder the same question every night. Is mom or dad coming home tonight? So all of you who are wives, husbands, sons, daughters, brothers, sisters, mothers, and fathers of any of us who were first responders or veterans, take a stand and look around.